of a sudden, the wild elephant stopped. So now what happened? The elephant has stopped. It came close to Aryathai, its face only inches away from hers. Now what happened? The elephant is very close to her. It's not only inches away. She opened her eyes and the elephant was there. So when Aryathai opened her eyes, what was happening? Elephant was in front of her. The elephant was staring at her and it stopped walking towards her now. They both stood still, not sure what would happen next. So now they both don't know what will happen next. Neither Aryathai knows nor the elephant is aware. Aryathai slowly raised her hand to touch the elephant's forehead. So now Aryathai has become so strong that she is lifting her hand to pet the elephant. It turned away from her and walked up the road to a low hill where a palmyra tree stood. So what it did when Aryathai wanted to pet the elephant, it turned from there and started walking towards the palmyra tree, a palm tree. There it stopped and stood still under the tree. So it went near the tree and stood without moving. It wasn't afraid when Aryathai walked up and tied one end of her rope to the palmyra tree and other end to its food. So elephant was not scared when Aryathai tied the rope to palmyra tree one end and the other end of the rope was tied to the elephant's food, because they don't tie the elephant from their neck, they tie the elephant from their limbs only. So Aryathai tied one limb with one side of the rope and the other side was tied to the palmyra tree which was near the road. If it had wanted to, the elephant could have broken the rope, but it was tired of running now. So now when Aryathai has finally tied the elephant to the tree, elephant couldn't untie it because elephant is also very tired of walking. The grandfather took a last bite of his mango and tossed it into the bushes. So now grandfather stole so much. What he did? Now he's almost finished his mango. After eating the mango, he threw the mango seed in the bushes. What happened then? Asked the girl. So now when grandfather told that elephant didn't run because it was tired, he just stopped the story. So now the girl is curious to know. So she asks her granddad, what happened after that? Well, no one came back to untie the elephant. Aryathai went home, but it turned out that Valapanikar had passed away during the night and then she herself died of grief. So what happened? No one went and untied the elephant. And when Aryathai went back home, what happened to Valapanikar? He passed away that night. Which was that night? The night when Aryathai went in search of the elephant. The night when she was in search of the elephant, Valapanikar passed away. And when she's back home, she'll realize that he's dead. And in that sorrow, now she's very much upset, she's depressed. In that depression, even she will pass away. So the elephant was left standing there on the hill. That's why there's a mark there. Because it waited so patiently for Aryathai to come back and untie it. So grandfather is telling, nobody went to untie the rope from the elephant's leg. So that elephant was also so patient enough that it stood for such long time that the ground over there went down. A pit was formed there because the elephant thought that Aryathai will only come back and untie it. The girl was quiet. She watched as he lovingly selected another mango from the basket. So listening to this story, the girl kept quiet and what did she do? She was searching for another mango from the basket. All right then, let's go home, he said. And he tossed the mango. I'm sorry, children. It was the girl. After listening to the story, the girl was quiet. And what she did was, she was watching at her grandfather as how he was selecting a mango from the basket. All right then, let's go home, he said. And he tossed the mango over to the palmyra tree as an offering. So what happened? Grandfather is telling, let's go home. So before they left to home, grandfather will throw one mango at the palmyra tree, telling that it is an offering. Understood? Thank you.